If there's a sequel for a live-action adaptation, imagine Olsen in the movie. That armor alone will cost millions. Olsen is the one character that I can declare as someone who won me over completely and didn't need to fight to make it so. Sure, there are likable characters that don't have combat skills, but since Olsen can't fight and has yet to raise his weapon, it's astonishing. All of his action not only scream a worthy Supreme Commander title, but so as Great General. This chapter only intensified that claim and more. Forget him as a monster, he's the devil. That last chapter mind-blown everyone in the field. It was so amazing. Even Earl Rye can't help but compliment Olsen and his outrageous tactic. Carry over from the last chapter's theme. Olsen can see the origin, but Earl Rye cannot. That proves how Olsen is above their level. Earl Rye even forcefully refused to believe that he can be better than Ryubuko. He's like a dedicated fan of one series that tries to deny that another series is better. The page with Olsen Army is oozing with greatness. I can admire it all day. Olsen doesn't stop to amaze me. Despite the fact he has the total advantage point, he still gives commands that doesn't make any sense to his men. All of his commands are seen idiotic, but the executions deploy great result. What speaks high volume to me is how Olsen commands his men to go to where Deremy's army is at, risking the chance of enemy wiping them out. But he didn't see it like that. Instead, he sees as saving the hassle and the opportunity to deal with them all in one fell swoop. That shows sheer confidence, boldness, and unfazed by any negative outcome. That's a true Supreme Commander. Once again, Olsen has mind-blown everyone, and by this point, I'm just flabbergasted how many more surprises he can dish out. The narrator takes over, describing the mood swing from everyone. Not a single one could have predicted. That's Olsen in a nutshell. A man that will always leave you feeling stupid. The narrator does a good job at leading you to understand the significance of this bizarre action. Sol takes action without any command. It's as if Olsen made a signal that reads, "Your move," like he's baiting him. I can only guess based on his Fu reaction. The tactic again is so bizarre, it even has Fute lost with words on what the hell is going on. But that's okay for us fans, because we can now point and laugh at him for being a fool, rightfully deserved. Ryubuko is gasping at Olsen's gamble, because he knows well enough that it is not. When a smart guy sees something only with high intellect can see, they are not dealing with an average commander. It's smart to use Ryubuko as the guy to elaborate the astonishment. Everyone would think this is chaos, but for Olsen, it's only Tuesday. He's very calm and unfazed by the possible danger as he commands everyone to form up. It's rather incredible how he went from something out of nowhere to something everyone in his army knows all too well. Hence, his men begin to form without a second thought. That's serious talent. Going back to Ryubuko, his eye can't see what was really happening, amazed by the end result. Somehow, Olsen made the Great Red Crane formation in the midst of chaos. Stunning. But that's not the end of it. I thought I would be numb to Olsen's surprise by now, but he just keeps on delivering. Although the formation is something his men know, he has something else in mind. Instead of getting to his position, he walks off and stands in the middle of an open field. Thank God there's no rifle, but there is bow and arrow. What are the chances that no one will think of shooting? It's jarring, yet badass of him to stand there. I like how someone thinks he's a fake. I mean, can you blame him? As crazy this has gotten, which says a lot, the follow-up does lead to amazing hype status. It begins with Ryubuko entering the field. Basically, Olsen called for Ryubuko to come over there, and Ryubuko responded his demand. I honestly have no clue what's about to happen, but I was mesmerized by the scenery, the chilling atmosphere, is deeply felt, like forgetting how to breathe. The two leaders finally meet face to face. They only go for conversation, but that alone is jarring, is eye-absorbing, and highly intriguing. Ribugo goes off first. His words can be summarized as attempted threat, even if what he said is what he truly feels. He has the courtesy to give Olsen a chance to surrender, and his men will live. Olsen takes it as a joke, quickly intensifying. While Zhao has his great disadvantage with Gyo, Ribuko is confident that their history will not fade away. This really gives me a good feeling that this arc is truly the final days of Zhao. I don't know history, so I'm only going by assumption. Regardless, the amount of tension is high. We are truly in the endgame now. Olsen's words, however, can be summarized as bone-chilling. It's not even his appearance that scares me anymore, or at least for the time being. It is how his words send shivering feeling. Zhao may have 160 years of history, but to Olsen, it does not matter. All it takes is a pack of imbeciles to bring the state to his knee. Wow, that got me chills. What struck me is how he knows very well that Zhao King is a pathetic piece of crap that wouldn't send the armies of Kantan. If he did, Olsen wouldn't have a chance. That's going to bite that douche really hard, and I'm going to enjoy it every second of it. How much it could have been avoided. All Zhao's hopes rely on Ribuko. Once he falls, Zhao is done. Olsen is a god compared to Ribuko. I mean, I credit him a lot for his past days, but Olsen is beginning to look unmatched. One last time, Olsen brings another surprise and possibly the final ultimatum. Instead of asking Ribuko to surrender or fight, he asks him to join his army. Not only the man or the devil is crazy to ask a foe to join him, but the amount of confidence that he will win is unfathomable. My brain can't register anymore. I don't understand Olsen's intention, but one thing is certain. He's breathtaking. Will Ribuko take it? I strongly doubt it. But if I was him, by this point, I would. The chapter was designed to build the hype for the grand finale, and it very well exceeded it. Olsen is the force to be reckoned with, and one that is okay if you submit. His tactics were incredible in more ways than one. The standoff at the end was sheer hype-inducing, setting up for an amazing climactic end. I have been hyped many times before, but this one really got me amped. Unfortunately, there's a break next time. When it returns, you can bet whole will continue to intensify. And that will do it for the review. I hope you enjoyed this one. I know I borrowed that trend whole intensify from Reddit, but it is funny every time I see it. But it is true though. Whenever Olsen says whole, it's either check or checkmate. Either one, you're screwed. What do you think of this chapter? Share your thoughts in the comment section. If you like this and want more of this, subscribe to my channel and my world will be yours to stay. Until next time, take care.